Hello everyone, welcome to RBR Life Science. In today's video, we are going to discuss the gram staining procedure. Gram staining procedure was first described in 1884 by Danish physician Dr. Hans Christian Gram. Since Dr. Hans Christian Gram was the first one to develop this staining procedure, it is named after him as the gram staining technique or gram staining. This staining technique is a differential staining procedure. The gram staining procedure differentiates bacteria into two major groups. The first group of bacteria is gram positive bacteria and second group is gram negative bacteria. Let's see how to do the gram staining practical. To perform gram staining practical, we need some apparatus. These are, first we need a liquid culture of bacteria, a sterile wire loop, clean and grease-free glass slide, and Bunsen burner. Then we need four different gram reagents such as crystal violet, grams iodine, 95% ethyl alcohol, and safranin. We need distilled water, forceps, staining tray, and finally, the most important is the microscope to observe the stained slide preparations. Now we have all apparatus required for gram staining. Let's begin the gram staining. The first step is the smear preparation on the glass slide. Take a test tube containing liquid culture of bacteria. Now by using a sterile wire loop, take out a loop full of bacterial culture by dipping loop into the test tube containing the liquid culture of bacteria. Now there is bacteria on the wire loop. Take a clean and grease-free slide. Place the loop containing bacteria in the center of glass slide and make a smear. After making smear, we need to fix this bacterial smear on the slide. Let the smear air dry for few minutes. Then we are going for heat fixation of the smear. Hold the slide with the forceps and gently pass the slide through the flame for about 2 to 3 times. Please be careful and do not overheat the slide. Now the smear is fixed on the slide and the slide is ready for gram staining. Second step is gram staining. In gram staining, we are going to apply four different reagents such as crystal violet, grams iodine, 95% ethyl alcohol, and safranin in a sequence. Let's begin. Keep the slide on the staining tray. The first stain we are going to add on the smear is the crystal violet. It is a primary stain. Take out crystal violet stain with a dropper. Flood the smear with crystal violet. Add the crystal violet on the smear in such a way that smear should get covered with the crystal violet. Wait for 1 minute after application of crystal violet. After 1 minute is over, wash the smear on the slide with water. Water will wash the excess unbound stain from the bacterial smear. The second reagent we are going to add on smear is grams iodine solution. Take out Gram's iodine solution with a dropper. Flood the smear with Gram's iodine solution. Add the Gram's iodine solution on the smear in such a way that smear should get covered with the Gram's iodine solution. Wait for 1 minute after application of Gram's iodine solution. After 1 minute is over, wash the smear on slide with water. Water will wash the excess unbound stain from the bacterial smear. Third reagent we are going to add on the smear is 95% ethyl alcohol, which acts as a decolorizer. Take out ethyl alcohol using the dropper and flood the smear with ethyl alcohol. Add ethyl alcohol on the smear in such a way that the smear should get covered with the ethyl alcohol. Wait for about 15 to 30 seconds. After 15 to 30 seconds, wash the smear on the slide with water. Washing with water will remove excess alcohol from the smear. The fourth reagent we are going to add on the smear is safranin stain, which acts as counterstain. Take out safranin with a dropper. And flood the smear with safranin. Add the safranin on the smear in such a way that the smear should get covered with the safranin. After the addition of safranin, wait for 1 minute. After 1 minute, wash the smear on the slide using water. Washing with water will remove excess unbound stain from the slide. After washing, let the slide with the stained smear to air dry for few minutes. The third step is the observation of the smear on the microscope. Now we are going to observe our stained smear prepared on the slide using bright field microscope. Place the slide under oil immersion lens and observe. After Gram staining, Gram positive bacteria will appear purple in color, whereas Gram negative bacteria will appear pinkish red in color. When both Gram positive and Gram negative bacteria are present in the smear, then after Gram staining, you can see pink colored Gram negative bacteria and purple colored Gram positive bacteria. For more information on Gram staining, please read my blog post. You can search on the Google, type Gram staining RBR. You can see my blog post on the top written on Gram staining by rbrlifescience.com. You will get more information on Gram staining principle, procedure, mechanism of Gram staining, and examples of Gram positive and Gram negative bacteria. You can also check your understanding by solving MCQ on Gram staining procedure. Go to the end of the post. Below the solve MCQ, click on click here and you can start solving the MCQ, which are very important for an exam point of view. In the next video, we will see the role of Gram's reagent in Gram staining.
So friends, thank you so much for watching this video.
If you want to watch such more videos, then please like, comment, share and subscribe our YouTube channel RBR Life Science. For more detailed information, you can visit our blog rbrlifescience.com. The link to our blog website is given in the description.